Imagine growing food anywhere in the world, whether on the equator or the South Pole, even in the desert. Our fresh water is getting depleted. Most of our water goes to agriculture. If we want to solve water, we need to solve agriculture. We need a new paradigm of how we're going to feed our planet. And vertical farming is one of those solutions.
Food security is a thing that every country is working on. And not only enough food, but sustainable, safe, and nutritious food.
Vertical farming enables local food production. So in areas like the desert, where you would otherwise import into a region, it's going to take some of those stresses off Mother Nature. We want to feed our planet. We need to do more with less. That gets really exciting. Vertical farms are level upon level of growing. We grow in warehouses as opposed to greenhouses. The fact that we're able to grow with no farmland makes it possible to grow using less than 5% of the water typically used by farms all over the world.
Deserts are already extreme climates. It's hard to grow any food in a desert. So vertical farming is more sustainable because it allows us to use a lot less water. So we're able to grow food on a large scale in an indoor farm. The Abu Dhabi research facility came about primarily because there is a concern for food security in the MENA region.
The UAE is very dry. It's classified as arid land. So there's little water and there's not much land which is ready for cultivation. The population in the UAE is 9.3 million. About 85% of food is being imported from abroad. We're working into issues like drought, saline water tolerant plants, salinity in the soil, the effects of weather and extending the life of plants in the open field. So the technology that we have developed perfectly serves the needs of this region.
Aeroponics is the way that we water our plants. Our greens are grown with just a very small mist of water, and that contains all the nutrition that the plant needs. And as a result, we use 99% less water.
We are growing plants suspended in the air. We don't use a substrate to grow. So our plants are free of pests and pathogens. Plants love oxygen. And it's been proved that the plants develop faster in aeroponic system compared to traditional farm. We can control all the parameters for growth, like temperature, humidity, CO2, and the light. Light is very important for the photosynthesis of the plant. Each color has a different effect depending on the crop.
LEDs are used as the primary light source in our indoor vertical farms. We're able to alter the spectrum of light so that we can optimize the spectrum to the plant's needs.
We are actually yielding almost 4 times more crop compared to land-based agriculture. Vertical farming can make regions with harsh climate conditions like UAE more self-sufficient because we can utilize non-arable land to grow the plants throughout the year. By combining biology and technologies like machine vision, machine learning, robotics, and artificial intelligence, we can produce more food sustainably that is nutritious for the growing population in this region and similar other regions in the world.
Technology is very critical for food revolution. The whole idea of controlled environment agriculture is to make sure that you're using the minimal resources with the highest impact. Agriculture is one of the most latent industries to start digitizing and relying on new technologies, whether it's satellite imaging, drones, smart irrigation systems. All of these are very critical for the enhancement of food production. We utilize lots of data collection to guarantee the healthiness of our plants. So we're tracking them in real time, making sure from seed to harvest that we know everything throughout that life cycle.
We can influence taste, texture, color, even the morphology of the plant, how it grows high or wide, the nutrient density, the shelf life. So imagine eating a great fruit or vegetable and wondering why it was great or why it was bad. The farmer would say it was too hot, it was too wet, it was too dry, it was too sunny. We're able to control those variables and deliver those environmental stresses consistently 365 days a year, 24 hours a day. There's a tremendous amount of technology that's going to reduce capital cost, reduce operating cost, and make circular economy opportunities even stronger. As renewable energy costs go down and we are eliminating a lot of the long-haul transportation miles, all of a sudden we have almost zero carbon footprint to produce food and to do it in areas of the world like deserts. So the ability to produce locally and reduce the risk from a food security standpoint is tremendous. Vertical farming is going to have a bigger and bigger place in agriculture. We have to think holistically, but ultimately it's this principle: how do we do more with less?